Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. I want to greet all of you in the mighty name of Jesus. I want to pray right now as we get into the word of God. Hallelujah. Let's pray. Father, we thank you in the mighty name of Jesus for all the viewers that are connected. I now bless them, O Lord, with the blood in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord. We bless your name in Jesus' name. For this broadcast, let it be anointed. Let your people be blessed in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. God bless you. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, people of God. I want to greet all those that are now online who are connected. I am so excited to come again. Hallelujah. As I teach the word of God today, I am teaching on a title that I have written, Refuse to Remain at the Same Level. Refuse to remain at the same level for too long. Refuse to remain at the same level. Refuse to remain at the same level. So I'm greeting Pumuzile Nkiwane. I greet Keith. Who is there? Ashley, Trish, Mandy, Kosi, Sanelisiwe, and many others that are watching tonight's broadcast. I kindly ask you to share and throw a watch party, maybe share with somebody. Can you invite someone online so that we just watch in our numbers and as I speak the word of the Lord. Hallelujah. So I'm teaching on the title, Refuse to Remain at the Same Level. Refuse to remain at the same level. Now, I want us to read the book of Hebrews. Hebrews chapter 11, verse 23. Hebrews 11, verse 23. Refuse to remain at the same level. This is the title of my message today. By 7:30, I will be done. Hallelujah. So we want to go to Hebrews 11, verse 23. I shall read. It says, by faith, Moses, when he was born, was hidden 3 months by his parents because they saw he was a beautiful child and they were not afraid of the king's command. By faith, Moses, when he became of age, refused to be called the son of Pharaoh's daughter. Now, which means he refused that level. He wanted another higher level. So he refused to be called Pharaoh's daughter. Choosing rather, verse 25 of Hebrews 11, to suffer affliction with the people of God than to enjoy the passing pleasures of sin. Esteeming the reproach of Christ greater riches than the treasures in Egypt, for he looked to the reward, to the greater level that was ahead of him. And by faith he forsook Egypt, not fearing the wrath of the king, for he endured as seeing him who is invisible. By faith he kept the Passover and the sprinkling of blood, lest he who destroyed the firstborn should touch them. By faith, They passed through the Red Sea as by dry land, whereas the Egyptians attempting to do so were drowned. So you are seeing here Moses improving with time, and he was refusing to remain at the same level for too long. He would move from one level to another. In every verse, there was a level up, there was a step up. So anytime, now listen, you remain at the same level, financially, spiritually, whatever, it's a sign of a curse. It's a sign of a curse, whether it's a generational curse in your bloodline. So, or maybe a curse that was released upon you through witchcraft. So anytime you remain at the same level and there is no change in even the tongues that you are speaking, because tongues, even spiritual tongues, they must graduate. Even the type of level of a car that you are driving, there must be an improvement year after year, because the Bible says we move from one glory to another. We move from glory to glory. So if you see stagnation in your life and you are at the same level for a very long time, you must have a time to pray and do some introspection, self-introspection, so that you really diagnose what is happening in your life. Because as long as you are a child of God, you must move from one level to another. The Bible promised us that we must move from glory to glory. It's a curse to remain in the same place or at the same level for a long time, whether be it physically, not growing. We call it these children who don't grow, they are called the FTTs, the failure to thrive, children that are failing to thrive. So I pray that you may not be a spiritual FTT, a person who is failing to thrive. You must thrive in life. You must move to the next level. Even as a pastor, if you are a pastor who is watching me, there must be an improvement that must happen at each and every level of your ministry and life. Once you see you are at the same level, then it's a sign that there is a problem in your life. Hallelujah. Now, can we read 1 Corinthians 13, verse 11? Hallelujah. 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 We bless the Lord. When I was a child, verse 11, I spoke as a child. I understood as a child. I thought as a child. But when I became a man, I put away childish things. So there is a time when we must move from being children and we must throw away childish things, which means we are throwing away that level and we are going to the next level of becoming a man. So you need to become a man. Hallelujah. So you must not remain at the same level. If you remain a child at a time you are supposed to be a man, we say there is a problem. There is a very big problem. And there must be some prayers, deliverance that must be done in order to break certain things that you are facing in life that are keeping you at that same level. Now, I want to talk about a man that refused also in the Bible to remain at the same level. This man is called Jabez. I think some of you have read about him. Let us go to the book of 1 Chronicles. 1 Chronicles. 1 Chronicles, chapter 4, verse 10. We will start from verse 9. Now Jabez was more honorable than his brothers, and his mother called his name Jabez, saying, that is 1 Chronicles chapter 4 verse 9. Now Jabez was more honorable than his brothers. Alright, he was more honorable than his brothers. And his mother called him Jabez, which was a name which means I bore him in pain. This was a child that was born in pain. And the Bible says Jabez called on the God of Israel, saying, "Oh, that you would bless me indeed," because he wanted the blessing of God, "and enlarge my territory." He was saying, "Can you expand me? Can you take me to the next territory, to the next level?" He was refusing to remain at the same level where he was called Jabez, which means a guy or a man who causes pain in life. So some of you, I see you are in this situation where you are a Jabez, even to people that you are living with. You are causing pain. You are always a dependent. Since the time you became an adult up to now, there is no time you sustain others, or you help others, or you nourish others. So you are the only one, even in your family, that is at a certain level that is of reproach, a certain level that is of embarrassment. So I want to speak to you today. I want to speak into your life a prophetic word in Jesus' name. I pray from today that you be removed from that level. May God break that spirit of witchcraft from your life. May he break that spirit of stagnation, the spirit of limitation, in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray today that you may move to the next level of your life. Yes, you have been reproached for too long. You have been embarrassed for too long. You have been grounded. Your people have been mocking you because there is no change in your life. There is no change in your status quo. But today I am praying for a miracle to happen. After this broadcast, may that marriage come in the mighty name of Jesus. May the next level come. I want you to refuse to remain at the same level. It takes a heart that says enough is enough. We now want to go to the next level. Now, I don't want you to get me wrong here. Hallelujah. Get me right. Get me right. Get me right. Now, I have realized something, that there is no way you can go to the next level until you get tired to the level, to the current level where you are. As long as you are still satisfied with that level, there is no way God can promote you. There must be a desire that must grow inside of you that says that I am now willing to go to the next level. I now want to go to the other side of life. And when you are angry and you say enough is enough, even all the demons that have been holding you, keeping you captive, they have to loose you. They have no choice but to loose you, but to let you go. Demons cannot let you go to the next level until you are tired. Until you are tired, you must say enough is enough. That is the only language that demons understand. They understand the language of violence. That's why the Bible in Matthew 11:12 says, "My kingdom suffereth violence, but the violent shall take it by force." So you need to take it by force. You cannot have an upgrade in the spirit when you are not yet tired of your current level. There is no way there can be an improvement or a step forward. Demons will keep you on that same level, pressing you on the same level. So we see a man called Jabez who was born in pain. He was born in pain and he was causing pain. The birth of this guy caused his mother pain. And even the life that he was living, it was full of pain. And there is one day, according to the book of 1 Chronicles, chapter 4, verse 10, when he called unto the Lord God of Israel. And he said, that word in verse 10, it's a sign of tiredness. It's a sigh of saying enough is enough. Oh, it's a deep word in Hebrew. That word, that is a sigh of tiredness. And he said that you would bless me, oh God. I pray that you may bless me indeed, that you may enlarge my territory and take me to another level. I am tired of causing pain. I am tired of being at the same level. I now want to go up higher in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. You must be ready to go to the next level. But I say, the next level until you are tired of the level where you are. Hallelujah. You must be tired of that level. Even I speak even to the people of Zimbabwe that you can't go to the next level as a nation until you are tired of the level where you are. You have to pray that God may bless us indeed, that he may expand our territory. So I want you to be prayerful in your life. I want you to challenge the level where you are violently and in your spirit. I want you to rise and say, enough is enough. I now want to go to the next level. That is the only time when you see your territory expanding, when you see things happening in your life. But as long as you are still comfortable at that same level, you are still relaxed, nothing will happen. You will continue being oppressed by demons, but until you are tired. Hallelujah. If you are not yet tired of your current level, I bet you, I promise you, and I tell you the honest truth, you cannot go to the next level. You must be tired like Jabez, who was born in pain and he was surrounded by pain. Everything that was around him was full of pain, and his name was a name of pain. His birth was full of pain, but there was a day that he said, oh my God, that you would bless me indeed, enlarge my territory, let your hand be with me, keep me from evil, that I may not cause pain to other people. Because wherever he would go, he would cause pain. But he refused to cause pain, and he said, bless me. And the Lord God granted what he requested. Which means all this time, Jabez, as he was growing, pain was around him until the day he decided to call, to challenge the pain that was around him. So there must be a day when you must challenge that pain, when you must talk to that pain, when you must speak against that pain. There must be a day that you must be angry inside of you, that something must rise, a certain desire that says, enough is enough, I am tired of this level, I now want to go to another level. That is when you get God moving. That's when you are granted your request. So God was watching Jabez all this time, seeing the pain that was in his life. And God was not hearing any prayer. So as long as God is not hearing any prayer from you, he takes it as you are comfortable in that situation. There must be a cry. There must be a certain fasting. There must be a certain movement that you must do in the spirit that shows that you are now tired of that situation. So if you are stationary in stagnation, it's a sign you are still comfortable with your stagnation. Now I repeat again, if you are stationary in your stagnation, it's a sign that you are still happy with your status quo. You are still happy with your situation. You are still happy with that environment, that condition, that situation, that circumstance, until you say, oh my God, until there is a sigh of tiredness like Jabez did, then there is a movement in the spirit to the next level. Then there is a granting that happens of a blessing upon your life, and God grants your request. He blesses you. He answers your prayer. So there is a certain prayer that God answers, a certain prayer that changes things. So they must be, because you cannot move a curve in the highway or on the highway in gear one. You must change gears. You must change levels. So if you remain at gear one or gear two, that is a level of starting the car or taking off. But with time, the car has to go into traveling gears. There must be change of levels. Even when you try to accelerate a car that is in gear one, all those who drive cars, you know, even it starts to complain, because it will be showing you that we are still in gear level one, and there is a limitation, a speed limitation on that gear. So if you want the next level of speed, you have to engage to gear two, the gear three, gear four, and you see now your car is now accelerating more than before. So this is what must happen in the spiritual realm. There must be a change of gears. There must be a change of prayer, a change of the way you fast, a change of the way you do your things. Then you go to the next level of your life. Hallelujah. So we must refuse to die in pain. We must refuse to remain in pain. There must be a cry that we must do unto the Lord our God. Hallelujah. Like Jabez did, and he said, oh, that you would bless me indeed. Oh, so even as Zimbabweans, we need to cry unto the Lord. It's time to pray for a change in our lives, in our situation, because we are causing pain all over the world. All Zimbabweans are everywhere in the world, causing pain in other nations, and they are full of pain in their lives. So we need to rise up as the body of Christ and pray for the status quo, even of our nation. And we say, enough is enough. There must be a movement. We no longer want to be called Jabez anymore, to be called people of pain, people that are living a life of pain. It's painful to get papers outside in South Africa, painful to cross the border, painful even to go to Europe and to stay there. It's pain upon the nation of Zimbabwe. And it's time for Zimbabwe to pray. It's time for the Zimbabweans to fast. And I want you also to fast as an individual, containing your life, containing what is happening in your life. And you pray and say, Lord, I now want another level in my life. So I am teaching on a message called refuse to remain at the same level for too long. Refuse to remain at the same level for too long. Now, let me just give you these notes quickly. If you remain at the same level for too long, your vision dies with you. Hallelujah. That is number one. Because now a cow that grazes on the same place, it overgrazes that pasture, and there is starvation that follows. So when you graze on the same place for too long, starvation follows, and you become an FTT, one who begins to fail to thrive. Now, I want you to write this point, number two. You cannot change your history, but you can change your future. Hallelujah. You cannot change your history, but you can change your future. So you need to change your future by doing something in your life. Number three, in David's life, there was a king trapped in a cowboy's clothing. Do you know that there is a certain level that is trapped in your status quo today, in your current situation? So there was a king inside. So if he had remained thinking that he is just a shepherd boy, he was going to die a shepherd boy. But he realized that inside of him there was another level. There was a king inside of him. And then he prayed, and God gave him that other level. Hallelujah. So even the clothing that he had was of a shepherd boy, until the day he desired to go to the next level. Now, I don't want you to die in the wilderness. Remember, the children of Israel moved from Egypt. They went to Canaan, and they refused to die in Canaan. And they went up all the way to Canaan. They refused to die in the wilderness, and they went all the way to Canaan. But unfortunately, it's only two people who reached Canaan. So there was a lot of miscarriages and abortions that happened there. Remember, they were there for 40 years instead of 40 days. So it is because they were now comfortable with the wilderness. Do you know that it's possible for you to be comfortable with the level where you are? You need to change. You need to go to the next level. You need to desire the next level. If you are comfortable with a one-roomed house, you will never own a four-roomed house. And if you are comfortable with a four-roomed house, you will never own a house with 20 rooms. So you must declare that I am tired of this level, and you go to the next level. Then Jabez, we are seeing him, he refused to remain at one place. We also saw even a woman called Hannah in the Bible. She had no children. She prayed and refused to remain at that level. She was committed. She was very committed to separate from those who were just dreamers, who were not doers. So I want you to know that there is a king in you, and you must desire to see that king manifesting. Hallelujah. So there are some people here that I'm seeing who don't know who they are in the spiritual realm. So the Lord was saying they must make some steps of faith. Hallelujah. Rakashakaba. I want you to write this down. Faith makes a Christian. Life proves a Christian. Trials confirms a Christian. Death crowns a Christian. And action upgrades a Christian. All right. I repeat. Faith makes one a Christian. Life proves a Christian. Hallelujah. Trials confirms a Christian. And death crowns a Christian. And action upgrades a Christian. Hallelujah. So when there is no action in your life, there is no upgrade. Hallelujah. So there must be action. When there is action, then there is an upgrade in your life. Hallelujah. Rabaka sakata da 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 da. Oh, zemakata katata da da baba. So I refuse. I want you to refuse to be an object that is just occupying space. I want you to move. Hallelujah. Rakasheke bete. I always teach people that the book, this Bible, it keeps you away from sin, and sin keeps you away from this book, the Bible. So if you want excellence, hallelujah, you want to go to the next level, you must be willing to do something 10 times better than others. You must take action. You must move. Hallelujah. So don't lead. Leading, even leading itself, you don't lead from the midst of the people, but you go a step forward. You must go on a certain level for you to be able to lead others, even in life. You don't lead in the midst of people. You must go to the next level of leadership. Then you'll be able to lead people. Hallelujah. You'll be able to lead people. Rakashaka baba baburebenderevekete. Oh, thank you. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Yes, I want you to know that as a Christian, what confirms us, it's trials. Trials are manure for the growth of a Christian. Hallelujah. We need this manure and then we will grow. So I want to tell you something that the Lord is saying, it's now time. I'm telling you, it's now time for our levels to change. Refuse to remain at the same level. I say refuse to remain at the same level. David refused to remain at the same level. Hannah prayed in a way that confused the priest. So we need to pray. Hallelujah. Now I want to speak something that we must pray even for our nation of Zimbabwe. We need to fast. I am declaring a fast. Christians must fast in the nation of Zimbabwe. We must fast, hallelujah, on Thursday. We must fast on Thursday. If you are a child of God, I am calling for a prayer and fasting. Let's fast on Thursday. I think you know what wants to happen on Friday. Hallelujah, the 31st of July. So we want to pray as a team and to pray for the grace of the Lord even for that day, the 31st of July. So it's time for us to pray as children of God. Hallelujah. And we need to pray for our prosperity as a nation. We need to pray even for the protection of the nation of Zimbabwe and the grace of the Lord. Hallelujah. So it's very, very important for us to pray for that day, the 31st of July. We need to pray. As long as you are in Zimbabwe, I am speaking what God was putting in my spirit, that we need to fast. The Lord was saying, tell the nation, tell the people that they must fast. The Christians, we must not just sit back. Hallelujah. But we must fast. We must pray. Our action is action of prayer. Hallelujah. Let's be in the spirit and praying in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let the will of God prevail in the mighty name of Jesus. And we are praying for the will of God. We are praying for the will of God on that day. We are praying for the grace of God. We are praying for the cloud of heaven to come down in our nation of Zimbabwe. Hallelujah. And we give that day unto the Lord our God in prayer in the mighty name of Jesus. I speak prophetically that we stand in prayer. We stand in prayer. So I'm declaring a fast. Today is Tuesday. So Thursday, all Christians that are watching me, who are Zimbabweans, we need to pray for the 31st of July. Let's gather, let's pray in Jesus' name and fast that day. We are not eating, hallelujah, in the spiritual realm, because the grace of the Lord must be upon this nation of Zimbabwe. We want the cloud of God to descend upon the nation of Zimbabwe, and there must be prosperity for his people. God is a God who answers the prayers of his people. And we go on the knees and we pray on Thursday in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. So all the body of Christ, all the people that are children of God, I call for a day of prayer on that Thursday, the 30th of July. Let's pray in the spiritual realm in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. So we want to pray right now. I just want some people to join me as we pray even for this day, the 31st of July. If you can speak in tongues right now, even before we fast. So I want you even tomorrow to engage into prayer. Let people gather in different groups and cry and pray in the spiritual realm in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. So let's go before God. Let's go before God. There are things in the spiritual realm, hallelujah, that are there, some which are coming in my visions that will transpire on that day, which I am not at liberty to say in public. But we want to pray. We want to pray. We want to pray. We want to pray for that day. We are praying for one thing. We are using, hallelujah, Psalms 23. And we are also using Luke chapter 22. Hallelujah. I want to show you the verses that we are using to pray for the day 31 of July. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So we are praying according to Luke 22, everyone who is writing. Hallelujah. So I want you to pray according to this verse which I'm now giving you. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. There is a verse that I want to give you, that I want to give you here, which was coming in my spirit as I was praying. And I want every Christian. Yes, verse 42. So we are praying for Zimbabwe. The theme verse for Zimbabwe as we fast on. There are two theme verses that we are using to fast for Zimbabwe, hallelujah, on Thursday. Now I want you to get these verses that we are praying using, hallelujah. Verse 42 of Luke 22, that is the top verse, which says, Father, if it is your will, take this cup from Zimbabwe. Take this cup of pain. I was teaching about pain, that we must refuse to be at the same level. So we are praying for Zimbabwe on that day, that if it is your will, take away this cup from Zimbabwe. Nevertheless, not according to your will, but yours be done. Nevertheless, not my will, not our will, but yours be done. Let your will be done in the nation of Zimbabwe. Hallelujah. Then we also use, whereas we will be fasting and praying, the book of Matthew chapter 6, Matthew chapter 6 verse 10, which says, your kingdom come, Matthew 6, 10, your kingdom come and your will be done in Zimbabwe, on earth, that is on earth as it is in heaven. Let his will be done in our nation as it is in heaven. So we are praying on the 30th of July, fasting. with Luke 22 verse 42 and Matthew 6 verse 10. And then we pray Psalms 23. Hallelujah. And if you can add maybe Psalms 91 as well. But there are two verses, Matthew 6 verse 10 and Luke 22 verse 42. So we are praying for Zimbabwe on the 30th. We are fasting 30th of July as children of God, saying, your kingdom come in Zimbabwe. Let your kingdom come. Your will be done in this nation. Not our will, but the will of God. What God is willing to do in our nation, let it be done on earth, which is in Zimbabwe, as it is in heaven. We want the will of God that is in heaven to happen in our nation. So we are covering and praying for that day, 31 July, in this manner, and praying for it as the body of Christ. God bless you, people of God. Hallelujah, for this prophetic instruction that I have given you as we pray as children of God. Remember, I said the theme verses for our fasting on Thursday for the nation of Zimbabwe and for 31 July, we are praying with Luke 22 verse 42, and we are praying also with Matthew 6 verse 10, and then we can add two chapters, Psalms 23 and Psalms 91. Hallelujah. And we are saying, let your kingdom come in Zimbabwe. Let your will be done in our nation. Let it happen as it is in heaven. As it is in heaven. We don't want the will of people, the will of men. Hallelujah. But the will of God. Whatever God has in store for the nation of Zimbabwe on that day, may the will of God happen. So the will of God prevails over the will of any man. So this is what we pray for. And the will of God is the best. Hallelujah. It's the best at any time. So we are praying for that in Jesus' mighty name and covering our nation in Jesus' mighty name. So as Christians, I want you to speak these verses and I want you to pray according to these scriptures on Thursday. Are we fasting, people of God? Are you agreeing with the prophet that you will be fasting on Friday, on Thursday? So if you want to stretch up to Friday, in the first 2 days for our nation, that will be very powerful. So we are saying, Father, if it is your will, take away this cup from Zimbabwe. Zimbabwe is a cup of pain, and we are saying, take it away from us. Nevertheless, not my will or not our will, but yours be done. Let your will be done. That is Luke 22, 42. So I want everyone, when you are praying, to say, Father, if it is your will, take away this cup of poverty and pain away from Zimbabwe. Nevertheless, not according to our will, but yours be done. Hallelujah. And then we will pray according to Matthew chapter 6 verse 10. Which says, your kingdom come in this nation, in Zimbabwe. Your kingdom rules over all other kingdoms. Hallelujah. When the kingdom of God comes, there are many improvements. There are changes. There are shakings that happens. So let's pray for the kingdom of God to come. It's the powerful kingdom. It's unshakable. It shakes everything that must be shaken. And let his will be done in this nation and on earth, which is in Zimbabwe in particular, as it is in heaven. We want what is in heaven to happen in Zimbabwe, in the mighty name of Jesus. God bless you, people. I love you so much and thank you for watching. Hope you have heard this prophetic instruction, this prophetic prayer that we are going to do, and prophetic fasting. It came when I was praying today, and the Lord is saying, we can't be quiet as children of God. We have to speak into the spiritual realm. Hallelujah. And during that day, when we are fasting on Thursday, every Zimbabwean that will be fasting, I want you to speak your desires in the spirit, the things that are in your heart, things that you are desiring for Zimbabwe, things that you are wishing for Zimbabwe. I want you to pronounce and proclaim those things in the spiritual realm. We all have our own desires for our nation. We know what's happening in our nation, which is causing that day to happen. So we want to pray our wishes to God, because God hears our prayers. The Lord was saying, I will be waiting for people. I will be attentive to their prayers on that day, and I will be hearing the prayers of the Zimbabweans. Hallelujah. So before whatever will happen on the 31st of July, the actions that will be happening in the nation, our action on 30th of July is prayer. We get into the prayer and we pray in the spiritual realm, and we speak our desires unto our God. God bless you so much. Hallelujah. Are you joining in, people of God, on Thursday? Are you joining? Hallelujah. Are you agreeing with the prophet concerning what I am saying? If you are in agreement, just type something and say, Papa, I am in agreement. I will be fasting for Zimbabwe on the 30th. It's not a day to eat. All of you that are watching me, it's a day to pray. Let the kingdom come. Let the kingdom come. Let the kingdom come. If you are joining, can I see those who are promising that they are joining, that you are in? Yes, I'm seeing Sandy saying I'm in. Rino Mota saying I'm in. Prophet Vincent Kazumba saying I'm in. And I see other people that are saying I'm in, that are going to be praying for the nation of Zimbabwe. Hallelujah. On the 30th, on Thursday, it's a day of prayer. Can I see those that are saying I'm fasting for that day? You can fast up to 4 p.m. Just drink some water. I'm seeing Seth from UK saying I'm in. And many people say I'm joining. I want a lot of intercessors to come in. Hallelujah. Some are saying Sisonke. Hallelujah. Am I in agreement? I'm in. Yes, prophet. Can I see many people that are joining, Christians that are coming in? Yes. Oh Lord, to fast and to pray. Hallelujah. So let's pray. Let's pray unto God. Prayer is powerful, brethren, in the name of Jesus. It's a day of prayer. It's a day of prayer. Can I see those who are voting for prayer on Thursday, who are saying, yes, I am in, who are vowing to pray and to be in fasting? Hallelujah. So I'm seeing many people that are saying they will be in. I'm so excited. Hallelujah. So this is so the direction that I've given you. If you didn't hear it, try to repeat or to replay and rewind this teaching that I was giving. Hallelujah. And also, I want you to pray in a mighty way. Now, even if you have got spiritual ears to hear the teaching that I taught you today, it was prophetic. I'm speaking something even to the nation of Zimbabwe in a teaching. Hallelujah. It was a prophetic teaching. Those who have got wisdom, those who have got ears to hear, you have heard what I was trying to say through this teaching concerning the nation of Zimbabwe. Hallelujah. It is also encompassing our nation. So with the teaching that I was just doing, it's a prophetic teaching which I want you to follow. So if you are in on Thursday, can I see you? You want to pray for Zimbabwe on Thursday, the body of Christ. I'm calling for Christians that are in Europe, Christians that are in America, who are Zimbabweans, who are in South Africa, those who are in Zimbabwe, for us to pray for the 31st of July as Christians with the verses that I've given you. Luke 22, verse 42, Luke 22, verse 42, and Matthew 6, verse 10. Then we conclude, as we are fasting and praying on Thursday, the 30th of July, with Psalms 23 and Psalms 91. So we will be in serious prayer covering that day in the spirit. And I said, express whatever you desire for Zimbabwe in the spirit and pray unto the Lord and talk to the Lord and say, let your kingdom come. Let your will be done in Zimbabwe as it is in heaven. As it is in heaven, exactly as it is in heaven. What God wants, what he desires, what he's planning for our nation, may it happen as it is in heaven. So we are joining in and we are praying as the Christians. Hallelujah. I hope my bata peteniacho, as I was giving you the information on how we are going to be praying. So thank you so much, people of God. Let me bless all of you. So follow the teaching. Follow the teaching. If you have spiritual ears, follow the teaching. It will give you answers that you want concerning 31 July. Hallelujah. The teaching that I have given you, if you follow it, it is a prophetic direction on its own. It will show you what God is desiring for that day. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Because we speak in riddles. We speak in riddles as children of God. Hallelujah. We speak through the scriptures. So whatever you heard, yes, I was teaching, it's a sign of what God wants. Hallelujah. So we want to pray in the mighty name of Jesus today. So I was teaching today on a title called Refuse to Remain at the Same Level for Too Long. It's time to pray. It's time to go to the next level in our lives. Hallelujah. So I want to pray for you in the name of, I said, refuse to remain at the same level for too long. It's time to go to the next level. It's time to go. So you must pray to develop yourself. You must pray to go to the next level. And I said, you don't overgraze the same pasture because you starve. There will be starvation. So I said, you cannot change history, but you can change your future. So we want to pray. Hallelujah. Let me pray. Thank you. In the name of Jesus. Father, I thank you. I bless your people who were watching, oh Lord, oh Father. They have heard and they are following in the spirit, oh Lord, the wisdom that I have given them, the prophetic direction on how we are praying for our nation on the 31st, as on the 30th, as we fast and pray. In the mighty name of Jesus, I release your anointing. As a prophet of God, I release your presence. I release your protection, your blood and your anointing upon all the people that were watching today. May you bless them, O Lord. I pray for power. I pray for fire. Rakabodobobodebede, mozobobobodebedebeketa, majegrahadiamangaza, alebogose. I pray for all the people that were online today. May you bless them. In the mighty name of Jesus, may you multiply them. May you protect in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. Now, this last few minutes, I want us to join. Hallelujah. All of us that are online. Hallelujah. And we want to pray and say, we refuse poverty. Hallelujah. We refuse to be at the same level in our lives. It's time for us to go to the next level. It's time for us to go to the next level. Refuse to be at the same level for too long. We want to pray for our lives. We want to pray for our individual lives. We want to pray even for our nation. We want to pray. Let's join hands in spirit wherever we are now. Can we begin to pray? Father, we thank you for this message. I bless your name, Lord. I bless your name, Lord. I pray for all the people that were watching in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray, O Lord, that you take your people to the next level. Yes, you are about to take them to the next level. O Lord, as I was teaching, I'm now praying for them. I'm now blessing them. I release success upon them. I pray for them for covering. I pray for protection. Marakatobobobora, every stagnation that was in their lives, may it go, every poverty. I rebuke it. In Jesus' name, I rebuke everything. I rebuke everything. I rebuke everything. I rebuke everything. I rebuke every demonic power. I rebuke every demonic force from your life. In the name of Jesus, of stagnation and limitations, may you go to the next level. We refuse poverty. In Jesus' name, we refuse the demon of poverty. We refuse oppression. We refuse any stressful situation that was around our lives. We break all the yokes, all the cords of the devil that were in our lives in Jesus' mighty name. Now we now pray. Now let's pray as we conclude for the 31st, hallelujah, of July. Let's just cover that day in the spirit as children of God. Father, we are now praying for the 31st. Moroko Tumunga. Majeje Marakata, those who can speak in tongues, just begin to speak in tongues wherever you are. Rekete manga, muzozo gomunganda, we are releasing your covering. Rakete kemunga, muzozo gomuremenga, mulenda garia manga, murondo momo 31 July, makasekete, muranda katutumunga, mulenda kakakaga 31 July, makaseketa, murenda katutukuma, mulandia moshe kemunda, marebro. Hodima, elebro hogobosede, no more poverty. Makita, murenda, mutsutsukuma, malikarita, mondeke, sisimunga, molobro hodiaga, indika tutumungera, enda murekashia. Alibra hazemega, endeke tutu mungrada, alebro hogigishia, andaka tutukuma, elebro, Jesus, your kingdom come.
Your will be done. Moreka tutu munga. Mosegete. Let's join hands right now all over the world and begin to pray. Rakato toborebede. Mokesekete de bokata. We refuse any stress. We refuse anything. Oh Lord, in our lives, any stagnation, any stressful situations, raka any poverty, we rebuke everything which is not of God. Rapoko seta mondeke tseke mungara ale broho diama mondeke tiaka ele broho dumanga ejima gadimanga azima gademare moje no to poverty, no more to poverty in the spirit. We rebuke it and we remove it in the spiritual realm. In Jesus' name, we remove it in Zimbabwe. We remove it everywhere in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Zimbabwe, Zimbabwe, be blessed. Zimbabwe, Zimbabwe, be delivered. Zimbabwe, be Zimbabwe, be redeemed. I prophesy unto you. I speak unto you. May your pain go in Jesus' name. I speak unto you. May your cries go away. I speak unto you. May your poverty disappear. Zimbabwe, Zimbabwe, I pray for you. We pray in the name of Jesus right now. Zimbabwe, hear the word of the Lord. Zimbabwe, you dry bones live again. In the mighty name of Jesus, may they be glory. May they be grace. May Zimbabwe become the bread basket of Africa. We are praying, oh Lord, for your glory. We are praying for this nation. We are praying for it in Jesus' mighty name. We release covering. I thank you, oh Lord, and I say it's done from today in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, people of God, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. I am done. See you again on Friday. Hallelujah. That is if we will be seeing the situation. But I will be coming back, hallelujah, with a prayer. We'll be praying 6:30 to 7:30. I'll be coming to pray with all the people, hallelujah, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Oh, yes, Zimbabwe. So I conclude, we are fasting for Zimbabwe on the 30th, hallelujah, and praying with the scriptures and with the prophetic direction that I have given you. May God bless you. Don't forget the prophetic tiles. Don't forget the prophetic tiles. I'm done about Zimbabwe. We are done. We are praying on the Thursday, 30th, for the 31st of July. We will be fasting and praying. God bless you, people of God. Those who know about prophetic tiles, don't forget. Please jump in and start to seed towards your prophetic tiles in Jesus' name. So all those who have finished are the ones that I'm inviting on Sundays to come and fellowship and minister with us, as we will be broadcasting under the number of maximum 50. So I will be inviting all those that have finished their prophetic tiles to come and collect your books as I pray with you, as I have that service with you. So you come once, when you finish, then you are invited to come again. God bless you so much in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. So we love you so much and we are praying for you. In the mighty name of Jesus, be safe in the spirit, in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. And may God cover you, may he protect you, in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We thank God.